this is Sufa PM TV. First of all, happy International Women's Day to all the ladies out there. Well, today I'm at the Royal Cliff Beach Resort to help celebrate the 70th birthday of a very special lady whose name could be synonymous with the word charity, Arlette Sigman. For those who are not familiar with this name, we'll take a quick look at her profile. Arlette's background is a colorful one. Born in Shanghai to a Russian aristocratic mother and half Armenian, half Italian father, she came to Thailand, what was then called Siam, with her parents and brother in 1949. Not long after, the Sigman family became the significant contributors to business in Thailand. From the introduction of the first ice cream factory, Dairy Bell, to dealing in bronze and yellowware, they added Thai silk to their products and built a weaving factory in Surin province, then opened a Thai silk garment shop in Bangkok, famously known as Star of Siam. After schooling in the United States, Arlette, who was then a professional skier, returned to Thailand to help her mother coordinate and design accessories for their shop. Arlette came to Pattaya in 1995 and became one of the founding members of the Pattaya International Ladies Club, known as PILC. This was to be the start of a lifetime devotion to improving the lives of the less fortunate. She also started the annual ball and initiated many ideas to raise money for the poor. Another of Arlette's project was the North Star Library that stands proudly on Sukhumvit Road, on a piece of land provided by the Father Ray Foundation, built and donated by her and sponsored and supported by many organizations. A lady whose contributions to the many charitable causes in Thailand earned her a medal who was pinned on her by an aide to Her Royal Highness Queen Sirikit and a plaque from the Mayor of Pattaya for her immense contribution to charity. And so today we are here to celebrate her birthday and also a success in her weight loss program.
Celebrating with me. This special event I shall never forget. I have become 70, that is for sure, though I don't feel it. But I have also met my challenge by losing 16.5 kilos for charities. I owe a lot of you a big thank you for trusting in me and helping me. Also to Rita for starting me off. I want you all to know that I will now continue to lose without the challenge to more or less reach my goal. You are all my friends, and I hope to have you around for many years to come. I believe we all still have many more good years ahead of us. My good health, may good health and happiness be with you all. Bless you, thank you.
I'm now sitting with the honorary birthday girl. Happy birthday, Arlette.
Thank you so much, Hu.
Arlette, you've been here in Thailand for so many years, for over 60 years, I believe, and you have international background.
Yes, I do.
And how, which culture do you feel you most relate to, that you feel strongly about?
Well, you might not believe it, but I feel a bit Thai, because most of my life has been spent here, so I feel more Thai than what I really am. Really, even though that I went to school in the United States, you know, I still come back here, and this is home for me. I love it.
Okay, and today is your 70th birthday. How does it feel to be 70?
Well, let's say it's true that I'm 70, but I don't really feel it. I feel, well, maybe around 50.
That's what I feel too, around 50.
Oh no, I think you feel much younger than that. No, but I'm of white Russian origin. My mother, who was a very artistic woman, who started the Star of Siam, you know, who was a very close friend of Jim Thompson's. And my father was half Armenian and half Italian. And his mother, when she was young, was Miss Rome, the first Miss Rome.
Wow.
Yeah, in Italy.
No wonder you're so pretty.
Oh, not anymore, when I was younger.
You still are. She's still very, very pretty. I always thought that, you know, she resembled, you look like, for me, when I look at you, I think of Elizabeth Taylor.
Oh, a lot of people tell me that, especially when I was younger.
Even now. Even
but
now.
I have met her.
You have?
Yes.
When was that?
Well, she came to our shop in Bangkok,
okay.
You know, with Bob Hope, long ago. Yeah.
Did you have a little chat with her?
Yes, but she loved kaftans, so she bought a lot of silk kaftans from us, you know. They were on the way to Vietnam at that time, you know, the USO.
Okay, talking about the things that you do here, you are a lady of charity. So I'm sure that you still have projects going on. Do you still have something going on? And what's the future of your projects?
I continue helping the poor, the children, you know. Whatever I can do to help them, I do, you know. And this now, Rita, she's not around here, Rita Cromwell, she has said, why don't you lose weight for charity? You know, because I never could really do it.
And when did you start it?
And I started on the September the 8th, exactly today, six
last
months.
Last year? Oh, 6 months.
Exactly, six
months.
Well,
it's only been 6 months.
And I lost 16 and a half kilos in 6 months, but it was very hard work, especially for somebody my age and my weight.
Wow.
But I'm not going to give up. I'm going to continue on until the end of the year. I'm going to try to see if I can reach my goal.
And I understand that this weight loss program is also for charity.
It is for charity.
What is the money going for?
The money will go, well, a little bit will go to the North Star Library because I would like to get some new books for them in Thai and English. And then, of course, it will go for the Ladies of the Mission and, of course, to Pattaya International Ladies Club because they need money quite badly this year. And also we're going to help some with some of the wheelchairs and some operations that have to be done. Because I believe that we should raise what I've been told is at least 200,000 baht.
So that gives you the motivation to keep losing
that
your weight.
That makes me very happy because I will help the unfortunate ones.
Well.
And that is what I've got in me.
But then, I mean, you cannot be losing your weight until you achieve your goal. What is your goal of the weight?
Well, I would like to lose another 20 kilos. Right. But I will start, as soon as I can walk even better, I'm going to start do more charity work. Because I want to do that. Because I think that's my mission here.
That is your mission here. It seems to be so. And you do a great job for the community here, Alet.
Yeah, I've started, you know, I'm the first one who started the charity bazaars for the PLC and the balls, and for many, many years I've been doing it for over 8 years, and so I've also helped in Bangkok when they had the fairs, and we've done fashion shows for the Queen of Thailand, for her charities and for the Rotary Club, and so I had some experience in it. So I want to continue to helping everyone that I can that needs help.
We thank you so, so much for doing all you can for the community, and we wish you all the best.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Sue.
Standing now with Judy Hoppe, and she is considered to be one of Alet's right hand, very close friend of Alet. Hello, Judy.
Hi, Sue.
What would you like to say about Alet today?
Arlette is one of the best people I've ever met. She has the biggest heart of anyone in the world. She thinks of everyone first, other than herself. Although at this point in time, we wanted to help encourage her to do something for herself. So in celebration of her big 70th birthday, she decided to take a weight loss challenge. And she's been so successful with it. She's lost 16.5 kilo, and all of the pledges that people have made will go to charity. And she just wants to help other people more than herself, but this time we're glad she helped herself as well.
We are too. Thank you, Judy.
Thank you, Sue.
We have the great honor to have Kun Panga with us today for the birthday party as well. Kun Panga.
Today is a special day for Kun Alet. She's a very good friend of mine, and I want to wish her happy birthday, good health, and prosperity. Thank you, Ka.
I'd love to wish Arlette a happy birthday. She's a beautiful person with a loving heart and so generous, and I'm so happy to have her as my friend.
I've known Arlette for, I think it was 8 years, and I've never met such a generous, caring, sweet lady. She's wonderful, and I'm just fortunate to have her as my friend.
Arlette, person I've known for the last so many years, is one of the warmest person and a very genuine person. Very happy to be in touch with her.
Yeah, she's a lovely lady, and we play mahjong together. So.
Hi, I'm Kathy Heinecke. I've been Arlette's friend for 45 years, and she's one of the most special people. I first met her working in Star of Siam in Bangkok, and we were doing a fashion show together, and she did all the designs, and I was a young, very impressionable, not very good model, and she was so nice to me even then. And they had the Star of Siam store, and she and her family, especially her mother Vera, have been dear, dear friends ever since that time, 45 years ago. And then when she moved to Pattaya, I don't see her that often, but we're still in touch by phone. And it's wonderful to know that she's 70 years old and still in such good health and having such a great time in her life.
And this is Leila August.
Hi, I'm Leila August from the Netherlands, and I've known Arlette for 5 or 6 years now. She was in fact the first lady that I met at the PILC coffee that I went to at Casa Pascal, and we sat across from each other and took an instant liking to her. She's a wonderful, wonderful lady.
Well, here we are again celebrating Arlette's birthday. Arlette is one of the staunchest pillars of the society here in Pattaya, and happy birthday, Arlette. Keep it up.
Dream that you had so long ago that lives in all.